job and I still, because I want to, because I have to. Yes, your boy Crypto Blood, and welcome to another episode of My Two Cents. Wow, today we're going to look at something very important. It's rolling out. It's a battle between a lot of the web browsers and the ISPs as internet service providers out there. They don't want this to happen, but it looks like it's going through. Most of the developers already have this feature enabled in the browser. So we're going to take a look at it. DNS over HTTPS and what and how you should handle it. You can enable it right now before it's defaulted. And we'll go through that in a couple of the different browsers. I use Brave browser, and you know, Brave is built with the source code of what Chrome is built on, and it's available in Chrome, so it is also extended to Brave browser, but you have to enable it in an advanced way. I would suggest only doing this on maybe your home computer, because most people's DNS settings on their home routers are probably like at default, so it's not as complicated. Not sure how well this will work on, let's say, your laptop, if you're going to various Wi-Fi networks, coffee shops and stuff like that. Their DNS may be set up a little bit more advanced, so it may not work. Okay, so try it on your home computer first, and then go from there. So let's go ahead and get into the actual article, because again, this is very important news. Even non-technical individuals should know about this, because this type of stuff is allows the ISPs to track what you're, you know, what you're doing, where your traffic is coming and going on the internet from your home computers. So let's go ahead and take a look at this article out of ZDNet, and it goes over the whole situation first and how ISPs are very opposed to this going through as a default feature and are lobbying hard. Of course, lobbying. I was talking to one of my buddies on Twitter about, he was asking whether voting or lobbying has a bigger impact. Of course, lobbying does, right? The fools vote. The fools vote. The smart ones lobby. Again, DNS over HTTPS will eventually roll out in all major browsers despite ISP opposition. DOH support is already present in all major browsers. Users just have to enable it and configure it. So it goes on to say that all six major browser vendors have plans to support DNS over HTTPS, a protocol that encrypts DNS traffic and helps improve a user's privacy on the web. The DOH protocol has been one of the year's hot topics. It's a protocol that, when developed inside a browser, it allows the browser to hide DNS requests and responses inside regular-looking HTTPS traffic. Doing this makes a user's DNS traffic invisible to third-party network observers, such as ISPs, but while users love DOH and have deemed it a privacy boon, ISPs, networking operators, and cybersecurity vendors hate it. A UK ISP called Mozilla an internet villain for its plans to roll out DOH, and a Comcast-backed lobby group has been caught up preparing a misleading document about DOH that they were planning on to present to U.S. lawmakers in hopes of preventing DOH broader rollout. However, this may be a little too late. ZDNet has spent the last week reaching out to major web browser providers to gauge the future plans regarding DOH, and all vendors plan to ship it out in one form or another. So, you know, I'm sure you guys know this is a crypto-focused channel, and I'm always telling you guys, download the Brave browser. It is going, I think at some point, will take over Google in the number, get very close. I won't say it's going to take over Google Chrome. Not going to go that far, but I will say it should usurp the second place in the very near future. Very good browser. So with Brave, again, it's built on kind of the architecture of Chrome. And so we can enable it there. But ZDNet talked to Brave, and they said that we absolutely want to implement it. However, the Brave team doesn't yet have an exact timeline for DOH's rollout. This is because Brave developers have been busy with other privacy-focused improvements. For example, yesterday the company released an update with improved detection of user fingerprinting scripts. Furthermore, version 1 stable release is on the horizon, so the Brave team needs to focus on that release first. Nevertheless, DOH will come to Brave. Implementing DOH is far more than just the technical work, though. they will need to decide on sensible and proactive defaults for the vast majority of people who don't think about their DNS configuration, while making sure that we don't break things for the people and organizations who have carefully tuned their setups. And so because Brave is built on top of the Chromium open source browser code base, DOH support is available. However, the Brave team has not configured the feature to its own liking. It is there in the code base, but in the way the Google Chrome team designed it to work. So the first thing you need to do is in your Brave browser, type in /flags/#DNS-over-HTTPS. And on the screen, as you see, you'll see an area that says secure DNS lookups. You can enable that and relaunch the browser. It's that easy. Now again, if you have some type of custom DNS setup even at home, then this actually might not work for you. So test it out and see if that works. Now for Chrome, as you can see, very similar. You just type in, instead of Brave, you do Chrome :// the same string of characters right after that. And again, you just enable it and you'll see the same setting there, secure DNS lookups, and just enable it and reboot. And as I've stated again, DOH is not turned on by default for everyone. Google is currently running a limited experiment with a small number of users to see how DOH fares in the real world. And you can find details at that link there. Unlike Firefox, which forces all DOH traffic to Cloudflare by default, Chrome's DOH support is different. After DOH is enabled in Chrome, the browser will send DNS queries to the same DNS servers as before. If the target DNS server has a DOH compatible interface, then Chrome will encrypt DNS traffic and send it to the same DNS servers. This prevents Chrome from hijacking an operation system's DNS settings, a sensible approach in enterprise environments. Currently, Chrome DOH support works like this. So, and I have to point out that because this is done this way with Google, your risk of never being able to use DOH is there. This is because a user's operating system gets the DNS settings from the central network authority, which is usually the ISP. If the ISP doesn't want to use DOH-friendly DNS settings, then you're never going to have DOH in Chrome. The good news is that there are two ways to bypass this and forcing Chrome to use DOH all the time, regardless of your ISP's DNS settings. First, there's the tutorial, and I'll link this, forcibly enable DOH in Chrome. Second, a user can configure a custom DOH-friendly DNS server for their operating system. So this is a little bit more advanced. And so then there are instructions on how to do it with Edge, which no one uses. And so Firefox really pioneered this DOH creation together with Cloudflare. Support for DOH is available in stable versions of Firefox already. You can enable it via browser settings section in the networking section, and you can see instructions below, and their configuration is in the connections section of their settings. There are some criticisms on how Firefox decided to implement DOH. Their implementation using Cloudflare as the default server for everyone effectively overwrites local DNS settings in that case. However, anyone can change this default setting to any other DOH server they want. Of all browsers, Firefox DOH support is the strongest and easiest to configure, primarily because they've been working on it the longest. The organization is currently enabling DOH by default for all users in the US. DOH won't be enabled by default for UK users following the UK government's pushback against the feature. And Opera here, if you're using Opera, you probably already know how to do it. You're probably a tech person if you're using Opera. And regarding Apple, there has been no reply from devs about DOH. They're usually late with rolling out this type of stuff. Apple has been recently investing in user privacy focused features, especially on their phones. So the chances they are pretty high that DOH will come to Safari. So yeah, I just wanted to give you guys an update on this and let you know this is something you can enable with a little research. I think you should try it out on your home computers at first. Like I said, you know, different networks have different DNS settings. Many times ones at coffee shops and restaurants and stuff, you know, have probably a more advanced DNS setup. So it may not work directly, but again, you can look at this article. I'll link it in the description of this video. I'll pin it at the top of the comments, and you can look into that if you're tech savvy enough. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Just want to give you that heads up on that new feature. It's not new really, but something that you can enable to improve your privacy even further. It's your boy Crypto Blood. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. And that's my two cents for today. I'm out of here. Holla. In a scary movie. I know I don't know how to act.